Hello friends, let us discuss waves today. I have taught this topic in the class and unfortunately we could not record that video properly. So let me do it for you today. And since you have already read about this topic, I am sure you will be understanding the concepts and the information easily. So, what are the waves? We all know that waves are just the transfer of energy. हम सभी लोगों ने फिजिक्स में पढ़ा है वेव्स कैसे बनते हैं, वेव्स क्या होते हैं. बट व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द ओशंस, द सरफेस वाटर मूवमेंट व्हिच इज एक्सक्लूसिव बाय द विंड्स, दे फॉर्म वेव्स. नाउ हाउ आर दीज वेव्स फॉर्म्ड? सो व्हेन वी लुक एट the surface of the wind of the ocean or the sea, so let us imagine that this is the surface of the sea and this is the wind which is coming from this direction, and when this hits the ocean water, it sets it into motion. When this particular water molecule over here, it gains this energy from the wind, it transfers this energy to the next molecule, it transfers this energy to the next molecule, and this is how the wave it progresses. We will come to why it looks like this, why this is the shape of the waveform. So most waves, winds are not the only factor causing waves, because there are different types of waves, but yes, most of the visible waves, they are driven by the winds. They are relatively small and therefore they release their energy gently, but we can sometimes see extremely high waves which are the result of the storms. They are not as the ones which are formed by quiet winds. Waves are moving energy traveling along the interface between ocean and atmosphere. So we should remember here that whenever two fluids, let us imagine that this is one fluid over here of certain density and this fluid is, and this is another fluid. This is another fluid over here. So this particular is the interface. Now this interface between these two fluids, it is the energy movement that causes this wave to fall. Now these two fluids could be either air and water, air and air, and water and water. The air or the atmosphere ocean interface, when the winds, the atmospheric winds, they hit the surface of the water, they impart energy and therefore they come into motion. Similarly, when two liquids of different densities are in contact, they show us the internal waves in the ocean, and so on. Now when these winds, the atmospheric winds, they impart their energy to the ocean water, they transfer it, and this wave, it carries out for long distances, sometimes as long as several thousand kilometers. All the waves, they begin as disturbances. Now most of us have played in our childhood by throwing a stone in a pond, in a still pond. Once we throw a stone, we see these ripples which are being created. And what are these ripples? They basically are the waves which radiate out in all directions. So, how are these waves formed? It's basically a disturbance. The energy that causes the ocean waves to form, it is called as a disturbing force. We'll look into this later. Similar to the rock hitting the surface of water, which releases energy and causes waves, similarly, winds blowing across the ocean water or ocean surface, it generates most of the wave. When the wind hits the ocean, it also radiates the waves in all directions, but it is on a much larger scale. Now, we all know that the waves, they normally are of three types: the longitudinal waves, the transverse wave, and the orbital wave. So, these waves, longitudinal waves, when the movement of the particles is parallel to the direction of the energy transmission, they are called as longitudinal waves. Similarly, what is a transverse wave? Transverse wave is the one in which the particles, they move at right angles to the direction of transmission of energy. While the third type of wave, that has the characteristics of both these longitudinal and transverse wave, they show circular or orbital motion, circular path, and they are called as orbital waves. So sound is a type of longitudinal waves. Light is a type of transverse wave, and oceans, they are orbital waves. Now, so this diagram that you see, this is an idealized wave. This is an idealized wave. Remember, in nature or in reality, it is very, very difficult to find a wave in this idealized form. We will see why. But this wave has been, this diagram has, you know, is normally exaggerated to show the features of the wave. आपको कभी भी इस तरीके की स्मूथ और वेवलेंथ और हाइट के रिलेशन की वेव्स नहीं मिल सकती, बट स्टिल इसको बनाया जाता है. सो हम सभी लोग जानते हैं दैट व्हाट आर दीज फीचर्स एसोसिएटेड विद द वेव. सो किसी भी वेव में वी कैन सी इफ दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन. सो द हाई पॉइंट्स दे आर कॉल्ड एज क्रेस्ट, while the lowest point they are called as trough, and the distance between two successive crests, do crest ke beech ki distance ya do trough ke beech ki distance, isko hum kehte hain wavelength. Ya if suppose this is one point over here, so ye point next kab aayega yahan par. So this can also be defined as the wavelength. The wavelength is very important characteristic. So these are regular symmetric waves in which you are being shown these features. What are they? They are wavelength, crest, trough. What is height? Height is the distance, the vertical distance between a crest and a trough, and half of it, it is called as amplitude. In the oceans, the waves are named on the basis of their height as well as wave period. And therefore, we come to see the classification of waves done on the basis of the factors which cause them. Factors which cause them. मतलब कि waves को बनाने के लिए कौन-कौन से factor हैं, वो वेव की हाइट क्या है और वेव का पीरियड क्या है, इसके बेसिस पर ये एक क्लासिफिकेशन दिया गया है। जस्ट गोइंग इनटू डिटेल्स ऑफ इट, मैं आपको कुछ छोटी सी चीज एक बता दूं, दैट लेट अस से दिस इज पॉन्ड, स्टिल पॉन्ड, ये पानी है, एक तालाब है, एंड यू ड्रॉप अ स्टोन। जब एक पॉन्ड में आप एक स्टोन डालते हैं तो होता क्या है, वी ऑल नो दैट रिपल्स आर फॉर्म, जो कि कुछ ऐसे बनती हैं। कॉन्सेंट्रिक रिपल्स एंड देन दे मूव फॉरवर्ड लाइक दिस, दिस वे, ऐसे। सो when these ripples are being formed, they are type of waves, but here we are seeing two different types of waves, and these ripples, ya ye jo bhi waves ban rahi hain, they have two factors, they have two forces actually. What are those two forces? Those two forces are, the first one is the generating force, generating force. What is this generating force? Here the falling of this pond, falling of this stone on the surface of the pond, it generates the waves. And the second is restoring force. Restoring force. So now the outermost waves over here, their generating force is this stone dropping in the pond. But what is their restore? So what is the generating force? That pushes it out. And what is the restoring force? That pulls it in. Yeah. So this is the generating force and this is the restoring force. So in the case of the outermost ripples, जो कि सबसे बाहर की तरफ हैं, जो बहुत ही आपको fine जैसी दिखेंगी, here the falling of this pond is the generating force and the surface tension of the water is the restoring force which will pull it back. लेकिन जो अंदर की waves हैं, the waves which are you know very very prominent center of the ripples, they have this falling of this stone as the generating force, but the gravity as the restoring force. Gravity. So these waves will be called as gravity waves. They will be called as gravity waves. While these outer ones, where surface tension is the restoring force, it will be called as capillary waves. Okay. So these two forces are very important, generating force and restoring force. उसी के बेसिस पे हम क्लासिफिकेशन कर सकते हैं वेव्स का। सो इफ यू सी हियर केयरफुली, इन दिस केस द वेव्स विच आर जनरेटेड बाय विंड्स, दे आर क्लासिफाइड एज कैपिलरी वेव्स, चॉप, स्वेल, सेश। Now, the second type of waves where the generating forces, they are storms and earthquakes. or landslides in the oceans. Some sesh are also caused by storms and earthquakes. Then tsunamis. Some tides are also caused by them. While the gravitational pull by sun and moon, it causes these tides. Going to the wave period and wave height. The capillary waves, they are very, very small, less than 10 centimeters height, and very small wave period of 0.1 second, followed by a chop, then swell. Remember, the swells, they are the highest waves, have waves having the maximum height in the ocean, the swells. They are even higher than a tide. They can range in height up to 10,000 centimeters, means they can attain a height of more than 100 meters. But they have wave period not exceeding 30 seconds. The shes is a type of wave which is generated by wind as well as severe storms and earthquakes. It has a time period of or a wave period of 5 minutes up to 5 minutes and a wave height of between 10 and 100 centimeters. Tsunamis, we all know how tsunamis are formed. So tsunamis can occur when there is an underwater earthquake or volcanic eruption or maybe a landslide. So the tsunamis, they are very fast moving but not of intense height. So the tsunami waves, they are fast moving. They can travel with a speed of up to 800-900 kilometers per hour. They carry enormous amount of water but their height is not much. And the last one is the tides. In the tides, we can see that they are generated by the gravitational attraction of sun and the moon, and they are the second highest waves in the ocean. So they can attain, so if it is a diurnal tide, so coming one high tide and one low tide in a day, so you will be finding their wave period to be 24 hours and 50 minutes, while if it is a semi-diurnal tide or a mixed tide, it will be having a wave period of 12 hour 25 minutes. So this is the basic idea about the waves, the types of waves. So in this table you can see what are the causative factors, wave types, and then the types of waves which we have just discussed. What are the factors that cause the generation of waves by wind? So wind generated waves, they are caused by four main factors. The wind velocity, which is the primary factor. The wind velocity is the primary factor. The faster the wind, the faster they will drag the ocean water. You can see several videos on YouTube where they have done experiments with wave tank, and they have switched on a fan which has very high speed. As they increase the speed of the fan, then the waves, they start getting very intense. So wind velocity is the one of most important factors, followed by wind duration. Imagine the wind movement is for a very short period of time, then definitely it will not be able to sustain these waves for quite long. Then fetch. What is fetch? Fetch is the distance in the open ocean from where the wind has traveled. So wind, in this case, in this diagram, you can see that this is the open ocean area, this is the coast or the shoreline, and this is the direction where the wind is coming from. So this entire area will be called as fetch, because this is the distance in the open, across the open ocean, where the wind has traveled. An original sea state, is it a storm weather sea, is it a fair weather sea, calm sea or very rogue sea. So that will also depend on how the size and variety and types of waves will be generated. So wind generated waves basically are progressive waves. When we say progressive waves, what does it mean? It means that the wind imparts energy to the water molecules, and then they move ahead, they keep on moving ahead. Now in this diagram you can see here that these winds, so if I draw it over here, so if this is the direction of wind from over here. It is hitting this surface. So what if you see here carefully, you are seeing here that these waves, they are moving and they are showing you a orbital or circular motion. In this case, the forward movement, this forward movement is not of the mass of water, rather this forward movement is of the wave form. So when we say that wave is moving forward, it is not carrying the mass, it is just that energy from the wave form which is moving ahead, while the mass or the water molecules, they remain at their original location. We'll see this. So what you should understand, that once a wave is moving, then the wave form is showing a forward motion, while the water particles beneath the wave are showing orbital motion. So if you see here carefully, these water molecules are undergoing this circular motion, but they are not moving ahead, they are coming to their original location. This is how a wave moves. So in a wave, normally the mass transport is not there, because wave is simply the transport of energy. And therefore, in the oceans, if you, see in this diagram, which is just a screenshot of the previous diagram, you can see here how these circular motions are being formed. And one thing you should understand, that in the ocean water column, the if we draw this, you can see here that this, that the size of the circular orbits made by these water molecules, it decreases with depth. Why? The reason is that the winds which are coming and hitting the surface of water will definitely not be able to impact the bottom water as they were able to do the top layer of water. After a certain depth, which is also called as wave base, beyond this there will be no motion, there will be no motion of waves over here. So the orbit, the radius of the orbit made by the water keeps on decreasing with the depth. Thank you. So if we see here in this diagram, you can see that in the surface where the wind is hitting the surface of the water, these arrows, they denote the movement of the water particles below the wave, beneath the wave. And beyond the wave base, there is no wave motion because the energy cannot reach over here. The orbital diameters, they decrease rapidly with distance below the surface. And therefore, the wave base is defined as the depth which is half of the wavelength. So, if imagine that there are two surfers and there are two people who are surfing in the sea, and one of them happens to be here above the wave base and the other is here below the wave base. So this person will feel the maximum impact of this wave motion because also remember, if he is closer to the surface, he will feel the maximum impact, and if he goes below here, this impact will keep on decreasing. But for a surfer who is below the wave base, he will never even find out that some wave motion is going above him. Okay, so this is just because below the wave base there is no wave motion. Now, theoretically speaking, if this is the water mass or the water particle, it undergoes a circular motion, comes back to its original position. So basically there is no mass transport, but actually it does not happen. What happens is the friction and the inertia, they cause this water particle to drift slightly away from the original position. So in the theoretical case, if this is the direction of wave motion, so this orbit, it gets closes after one orbital period, so basically there is no net mass transport. But due to the friction, this orbit, it does not get closed, rather it remains open and the particles move slightly ahead from its original position. This is called as Stokes drift. Okay, so in this case there will be a slighter mass movement as well. So the same thing over here. So जो अभी तक मैं आपको समझाया, आप उसको समझने इस डायग्राम से देखने की कोशिश कीजिए कि एक डक है. This duck, जैसे जैसे इसके पास क्रेस्ट आता जाएगा, as the crest comes closer to this duck, ये पीछे की तरफ और ऊपर की तरफ उठता जाएगा, और जैसे जैसे इसके पास ट्रफ आएगा तो ये नीचे और आगे की तरफ मूव करेगा. सो दिस इज व्हाट इट सेज कि व्हेन द क्रेस्ट अप्रोचेस द डक रबर डक, इट मूव्स अप एंड बैकवर्ड, व्हाइल व्हेन द ट्रफ अप्रोचेस द डक, इट मूव्स इट फॉरवर्ड एंड अप, एंड व्हेन इट एंटर्स द ट्रफ, इट मूव्स डाउन एंड फॉरवर्ड. सो दैट इज हाउ इट मेक्स अ फुल सर्कल. And the same diagram, so you can see here that in this wave, this is the crest and the trough, and what you can see over here is that the orbital motion of the water particles, it reduces from the surface to the wave base. Now there are two more terms, deep water wave and shallow water wave. The deep water waves are those waves where the waves do not touch the ocean or the sea bottom. वहाँ पर जो waves हैं वो sea bottom को impact नहीं कर पाती. इस केस में क्या होगा कि let us imagine that this is the sea surface and this is the sea floor. This is the wind direction, and so the waves move this way. So what will happen? Let us say we just create a wave this way. So this becomes the wavelength. So if this is the wavelength, then half of this wavelength, let us say this, will be the wave base. Now, in this case, the top layer will be showing a orbital motion, followed by a smaller orbit, followed by a smaller orbit, and then the smallest orbit. Similarly over here, this way, this way, this way, this way. Here what we can see is, let me make it circular. Yeah, so what we can see here is that the waves, they are not touching the wave bottom. So they are not touching it over here. So once they are not touching the wave bottom, then what happens is that they complete their orbital motion and they give us the circular orbit. So this happens in the open ocean, where the sea floor is much deeper than the wave base, which is half of the wavelength, 1 by 2 lambda. But when it comes to shallower portions, so if this is the sea level, and let us say that this is the sea floor. Here, the sea floor is interacting with the wave. So what will happen? This back and forth, so water on the sea floor will keep on interacting. As a result, you will not be getting circular orbits, rather you will be getting elliptical orbits like this. So in this case, the waves over here, they will be called as shallow water waves, and the previous case was of deep water waves. So if we see over here, we can see that when the water depth, so if this is the water depth from over here, let us say this is the water depth. When the water depth is more than half of the wavelength, means when the water depth is more than the wave base, then the waves will be called as a deep water wave. While when the water depth is less than 1/20th of wavelength, means much, much less than the wave base, it will be called as shallow water wave. And in this case, what will happen is that in the deep water waves, you get circular orbits. Here you will get elliptical orbits. Okay, so I have taken these two pictures from internet, and let us see how do they look like. So let me draw over here. So this is an open ocean wave. So if I draw this motion of orbit over here, you can see it's almost circular. I'm not very good at drawing this. See this, can you see these crests? So what will happen over here in this open ocean, aapko ye ek circular orbit dikhai degi. Lekin jaise jaise ye, आप लोगों ने अक्सर जब आप बीच पे जाएंगे और आप लोगों ने देखा होगा सर्फर्स को, तो वो जब शोर के पास वो सर्फिंग करते हैं, तो आप ये देखो, कैन यू सी दिस एलिप्टिकल शेप, ये दिस एलिप्टिकल शेप ऑफ द वेव, यही हमें बताता है कि दिस इज नाउ अप्रोचिंग द शोर. अदरवाइज यहां पर जो भी मूवमेंट होती वो कंप्लीटली सर्कुलर होती, बट जैसे जैसे ये नियर शोर पहुंचते हैं, ये एलिप्टिकल होने स्टार्ट हो जाते हैं. ऐसा क्यों होता है? क्योंकि यहां पर जो वाटर डेप्थ है वो वेव बेस से कम है. एज अ रिजल्ट द वेव्स दे इंटरैक्ट विद द सी बॉटम, एंड देयरफॉर द ऑर्बिटल मोशन it becomes elliptical in case of near shore or shallow water waves. So let us now look at the wave speed. जैसे अब हम लोग किसी भी moving body की speed निकालते हैं तो वो क्या करते हैं, the distance travelled upon time taken. Similarly, wave speed को कभी कभी celerity भी कहा जाता है, celerity. Celerity. So how is celerity defined? Celerity is defined as the wavelength divided by wave period. In shallow water waves, the wave speed can be calculated with different constants. So where 1.56 multiplied by the wave period, or 1.25 into square root of the wavelength, or 3.13 into square root of the water depth. So agar aapke paas isme se koi bhi ek value rahegi to aap wave ki speed calculate kar sakte hain. You can try this question with whatever numbers you want. You should remember these formula, ye aapko aage kaam aayenge. एक और टर्म है वेव स्टीपनेस, जिसके बारे में हम लोग बाद में भी बात करेंगे. वेव स्टीपनेस जो होती है, इट इज नोन एज द रेशियो ऑफ हाइट ऑफ द वेव टू दैट ऑफ द वेवलेंथ ऑफ द वेव, हाइट ऑफ द वेव टू दैट ऑफ द वेवलेंथ. और ये बहुत सारे एक्सपेरिमेंट्स के बाद और ऑब्जर्वेशंस के बाद ये देखा गया है कि when this wave steepness is 1 upon 7, that is, मान लीजिए कि कोई भी एक वेव है जिसकी हाइट है 7 meter, सॉरी जिसकी वेवलेंथ है 7 meters, तो उसकी हाइट 1 meter से ज्यादा नहीं हो सकती, अदरवाइज दैट वेव विल नॉट बी एबल टू कैरी इटसेल्फ, वो टूट जाएगी. सो लेट अस सपोज दैट this is a wave और ये इसकी wavelength है between two crest and this wavelength is 7 meters, तो इसकी जो wave height है, ये इसकी जो wave height है ये, sorry, let me draw it again for you, sorry guys. So if this is a wave and the wavelength it is 7 meters, so this height cannot be more than 1 meter, because in that case if the steepness is different than 1/7 or less, more than 1/7, in that case the wave will break. जब भी आप लोग देखते होंगे कि एक ऐसा wave चला आ रहा है, जैसे ही shore के पास आया, it breaks. Why does this break? Because there the steepness becomes more than 1:7. So for example, एक wave है जिसकी wavelength is 14 meters. तो उसकी हाइट 2 meter से ज्यादा नहीं हो सकती. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट. सो कीप दिस वैल्यू इन माइंड दैट फॉर द वेव्स टू कंटिन्यू फॉर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेस, द वेव स्टीपनेस शुड बी नॉट मोर देन 1:7. ओके, बिकॉज जब भी वेव स्टीपनेस 1:7 से ज्यादा होगी, वेव्स विल ब्रेक, दे विल कॉज द वेव ब्रेकर्स. After this, let us come to the harmonic analysis of waves. Waves can be chaotic waves, and then waves can be normal waves, you know, ordered or a regular wave. So whenever the sea is very very turbulent, कई बार होता है ऐसा कि बहुत ज़्यादा हवा चल रही होती है, बहुत windy या stormy sea है. उस केस में द ओशन ऑफ द सी शोज वेरी इररेगुलर पैटर्न, बहुत ज्यादा इररेगुलर पैटर्न उसमें दिखाई देता है. ऐसा इसलिए होता है कि अलग अलग डायरेक्शन से अलग अलग हाइट, अलग अलग वेवलेंथ और अलग अलग पीरियड्स की वेव्स आती हैं जो मर्ज करती हैं, और जब वो मर्ज करती हैं उसको हम कहते हैं वेव इंटरफेरेंस. अभी देखते हैं वेव इंटरफेरेंस भी अलग अलग तरीके का हो सकता है. एक सिंपल सा एग्जाम्पल आपको मैं देता हूँ. आप लोग शॉपिंग मॉल्स वगैरह में जाते हैं और जब आप एस्केलेटर्स यूज करते हैं, कुछ लोगों की आदत होती है कि वो एस्केलेटर्स के साथ साथ चलने लगते हैं। जब वो एस्केलेटर के डायरेक्शन में, जैसे नीचे से ऊपर की तरफ अगर एस्केलेटर जा रहा है और आप भी उसी डायरेक्शन में चलने लगे, तो आप एक कंस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस बनाते हैं, यानी आपकी जो एपरेंट स्पीड है वो बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है। लेकिन अगर आप इसका उल्टा करें कि अगर वो एस्केलेटर वो नीचे की तरफ जा रहा है और आप उस एस्केलेटर के उल्टा चलने लगेंगे, तो आपकी जो एपरेंट स्पीड है वो कम हो जाएगी, बिकॉज नाउ देयर यू आर यूजिंग द डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस। तो मान लीजिए कि एक वेव आ रही है जिसका क्रेस्ट और ट्रफ दूसरी वेव से कोइंसाइड कर गया, तो उस केस में जो रिजल्टेंट वेव होगी उसका जो हाइट होगा इट विल इंक्रीज। लेकिन अगर मान लीजिए कि एक किसी वेव का क्रेस्ट दूसरे वेव के ट्रफ के साथ मैच करता है, तो उस केस में देयर विल बी अ डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस। लेट अस सी व्हाट इट इज। सो आप ये देख सकते हैं कि अगर ये एक ऐसी वेव प्रोफाइल आपको दिखाई दे रही है फेच में, यानी द डिस्टेंस अक्रॉस विच द विंड हैज ट्रेवल्ड, और इसके अंदर आप देख सकते हैं कि ये तो रिजल्टेंट है जो आपको मिल रहा है, बट दिस कुड बी अ रिजल्ट ऑफ सेवरल ऑफ दीज वेव्स विच कैन शो कंस्ट्रक्टिव और डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंसेस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अब ये ऊपर की दो वेव्स आप देखिए, ऊपर की द टॉप वेव का जहां पर ट्रफ आ रहा है, नीचे वाली वेव का क्रेस्ट वहां पर जाकर के मैच कर रहा है। ठीक उसी तरीके से उसके नीचे की वेव देखो, सो द क्रेस्ट एंड ट्रफ दे आर मैचिंग। और थोड़ा नीचे आते हैं तो आप ये देख सकते हैं कि यहां पर भी क्रेस्ट और ट्रफ मैच हो रहे हैं, बट हियर यू कैन सी that the crest is at some places the crest is matching with crest and trough is matching with trough. तो इस केस में वो दूसरे तरीके से इंटरफेरेंस हो रहा है। तो इधर देखते हैं कि here we have two waves of different heights h1 and h2. These two waves, they are showing that their troughs are in sync and their crest are in sync, यानी ट्रफ मैच कर रहा है दूसरे वेव के ट्रफ के साथ और क्रेस्ट मैच कर रहा है क्रेस्ट के साथ। This is called as constructive interference, जिसमें wave height will be the addition of these two. It will be the addition of these two. अगर हम ऐसा केस देखते हैं जिसमें the trough of the higher wave, जो जिसकी वेव हाइट ज्यादा है, हायर वेव का ट्रफ अगर लोअर वेव के क्रेस्ट से मैच कर रहा है और इसका जो क्रेस्ट है वो इधर के ट्रफ से मैच कर रहा है, यानी दिस इज अ डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस। सो व्हाट विल हैपन ओवर हियर, हियर द रिजल्टेंट वेव हाइट विल बी h1 माइनस h2। लेकिन कभी कभी ऐसा भी होता है कि किसी दो ऐसी वेव है जिसमें एक वेव बहुत बड़ी है, too big, जिसमें इसका जब क्रेस्ट कंप्लीट हो रहा है उसमें छोटी वेव का एक पूरा वेवलेंथ आ जा रहा है। So you can see here that the half wavelength of the larger wave, it is including the wavelength, complete one wavelength of the smaller wave, यानी बड़ी वेव का जो हाफ वेवलेंथ है उसमें छोटी वेव का एक पूरा वेवलेंथ आ रहा है। तो ऐसे केस में इसका हाइट क्या होगा, सपोज करिए कि ये हाइट बड़े वेव की h1 है और इसकी h2 है, सो ये हाफ हो जाएगा, तो h1 प्लस हाफ h2 माइनस हाफ h2। तो आप ये देख सकते हैं यहां पर कि रिजल्टेंट वेव किस तरीके से यहां पर ये ऐड हो रही है, यानी कि जहां तक ये इसके कंस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस में होगा यहां पर ये ऐड होगा, और जहां पर ये डिस्ट्रक्टिव इंटरफेरेंस में होगा ये माइनस हो जाएगा, सबट्रैक्ट हो जाएगा। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स इंटरफेरेंस, और यहां पर एक इररेगुलर वेव बनेगी। व्हेन वी लुक एट द ओशन, सो कैओटिक सिस्टम में हम लोगों ने देखा कि जब भी किसी ओशन में कैओटिक वेव्स होती हैं, तो वो chaotic waves इसलिए होती हैं क्योंकि अलग अलग डायरेक्शन से अलग अलग प्रॉपर्टीज की वेव्स आती हैं और उनके अंदर इंटरफेरेंसेस होते हैं, लेकिन कई बार रेगुलर ओशन वेव्स आती हैं और उनका जो टाइम पीरियड, देयर टाइम पीरियड इज यूनिफॉर्म, देयर कॉल्ड एज ओशन स्वेल्स. सो हियर इफ दिस इज द विंड डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम दिस डायरेक्शन इज कमिंग टुवर्ड्स दिस, सो यू कैन सी हियर हाउ दीज waves, they are coming on a regular pattern, they are called as swells. Swells, aur hum logo ne shuru mein hi dekha tha that swells are the highest waves. So seas are irregular in the fetch area, jo fetch area hai sea ka, the open ocean area, wahan par, ya open sea area, wahan par because of constructive and destructive wave interference they are irregular. Fetch ke bahar aane par, jaise jaise aap क्लोज टू दी शोर लाइन जाते हो, द ओशन बिकम्स वेरी रेगुलर एंड दे फॉर्म द स्वेल्स. तो ये स्वेल जो है ये अपने आप को स्पीड के अकॉर्डिंग सॉर्ट आउट करते हैं एंड दे हैव अ यूनिफॉर्म टाइम इंटरवल. While the third type, so we had the chaotic waves, we had the ocean swells, and the third one is the breakers. So breakers क्या होते हैं कि these breakers they dissipate their energy at the shoreline where the waves collapse. और हम लोगों ने ये देखा था that when the wave steepness is more than 1:7, then the they form breakers. So these breakers they finally hit the coast, they dissipate their energy at the coast, and they do the you know weathering and erosion of the coast and form the coastal geomorphology. When we look at the shallow water wave transformations, hum logon ne dekha tha pichli slides mein how the wave celerity is calculated for a shallow water wave, yani ki abhi jab hum we are getting closer to the coast jahan par the water depth is much shallower than the wave base. So, उस केस में द सेलेरिटी इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय द फॉर्मूला C इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट जी डी वेयर जी इज द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. सो देयरफॉर इफ यू कैलकुलेटेड इट बिकम्स 3.13 रूट डी एंड डी इज द वाटर डेप्थ. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू वांट टू कैलकुलेट द स्पीड ऑफ अ शैलो वाटर वेव वेयर द डेप्थ इज लेट अस से 9 मीटर्स, सो it will the celerity will be approximately 10 meter per second because 9 ka square root is 3, so 3 multiplied by 3.13 that comes approximately as 10, so it will be 10 meters per second. Ab baat ye hai ki as the waves they approach the shoreline, so what happens open ocean mein where the water depth is water is quite deep, much deeper than the wave base, so you will be getting the waves which have longer wavelength. आप ये देख सकते हैं इधर कि ये wavelength जो है they are quite long. जैसे जैसे ये shallow water depth में आते हैं, as they come towards shallow water depth and they interact with the sea bottom, then the energy of the waves it will push the water vertically up. जो एनर्जी है वाटर का वो उसको वर्टिकली ऊपर की तरफ उठाता है. एज अ रिजल्ट द हाइट ऑफ द वेव इंक्रीजेस बट द वेवलेंथ डिक्रीजेस. सो वेवलेंथ कम हो जाएगी और वेव हाइट बढ़ जाएगी, लेकिन एक चीज जो कांस्टेंट रहेगी, जो फिक्स रहेगी, वो होगा वेव पीरियड. सो वेव पीरियड जो है वो वेव की ऐसी फंडामेंटल प्रॉपर्टी है जो बदलती नहीं है. So, एक वेव अगर ओपन ओशन से कोस्ट की तरफ आ रही है तो उसका वेव पीरियड सेम होगा, उसकी वेवलेंथ चेंज हो सकती है, उसकी हाइट चेंज हो सकती है, बट उसकी वेव पीरियड चेंज नहीं होगी. दिस यू शुड ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज द वेव डिस्पर्शन. कई बार क्या होता है कि हम लोगों ने देखा है कि जब ओपन सी से या ओपन ओशन से वेव्स ट्रेवल करती है कोस्ट एरियाज की तरफ, तो जो हेडलैंड होता है यानी कि बाहर की तरफ निकला हुआ जो रॉक क्लिफ है उससे वेव्स टकरा करके डिस्पर्स करती है. तो जब इम्बेमेंट एरिया, जहां पर बीच है, जहां पर आप देख सकते हैं कि ये किस तरीके से एक इनवर्ड कर्व्ड एरिया है, वहां पर वेव्स अपनी एनर्जी को धीरे धीरे डिसिपेट करती हैं, इसलिए वहां पर बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग वेव्स नहीं मिलते। लेकिन हेडलैंड पे जब ये वेव्स टकराती हैं, देन दे आर द हाई एनर्जी जोन। सो यही हेडलैंड, क्योंकि हेडलैंड पर जो डिस्पर्शन, द डिस्पर्शन विच इज बीइंग कॉज्ड एट द हेडलैंड, इट इज ऑफ वेरी हाई एनर्जी, इट स्टार्ट्स इरोडिंग द क्लिफ। सो धीरे धीरे यही जो क्लिफ है, इट स्टार्ट्स यू नो गेटिंग ब्रोकन ऑफ एंड फॉर्म्स द इम्बेमेंट, एंड देन दोज पार्टिकल्स द सेडिमेंट्स दे फॉर्म द बीच ओवर देयर। सो द वेव डिस्पर्शन, इन द वेव डिस्पर्शन यू कैन सी हियर दैट द पोर्शन ऑफ द मेन लैंड विच इज प्रोट्रूडिंग टूवर्ड्स द ओशन, जो कि सी या ओशन की तरफ है, वहां पर जब वेव टकराएगी तो वहां पर उसकी एनर्जी ज्यादा होगी, और वेव डिस्पर्शन जो है वहां पर क्या करेगा, सभी वेव्स को इकट्ठा करेगा, इट विल ब्रिंग टुगेदर द वेव्स, द वेव एनर्जी, व्हाइल इन द इम्बेमेंट ये स्प्रेड करेगा, व्हेन इट स्प्रेड्स इट बिकम्स द लो एनर्जी जोन। सो द वेव डिस्पर्शन कॉजेज द एनर्जी ऑफ द वेव्स टू इंक्रीज एट द हेडलैंड, व्हाइल इट डिक्रीजेस ड्यू टू डिस्पर्शन एट द इम्बेमेंट रीजन। So, for example, in this photograph, if you can see here, that if I show this to you, so you can see here that the headlands, they are showing the wave energy concentrated, which makes it high energy zone. लेकिन जो embayment area है, वहाँ पर आप देखिए कितना smoothly ये dispersion हो रहा है. Let us now see the shore breakers. So, जैसा मैंने आपको पहले बताया था. Wave steepness is the ratio of wave height to that of wavelength. So, ये क्या होता है? Remember, shore breakers कब बनेंगे? When the wave becomes unstable. Unstable का मतलब when they cannot hold the energy, they cannot transfer the energy to the water anymore. So, critical wave steepness is 1:7. यानी कि 7 meter wavelength के लिए 1 meter से ज्यादा की वेव नहीं हो सकती, उससे कम होगी चलेगा, उससे ज्यादा की वेवलेंथ नहीं हो सकती, क्योंकि अगर वो हुई तो वेव अनस्टेबल हो जाएगी, जो क्रेस्ट है वो ओवर स्टीप हो जाएगा और वो टूट जाएगा। सो द शोर ब्रेकर्स देयर ऑफ 3 टाइप्स, द स्पिलिंग ब्रेकर, प्लंजिंग ब्रेकर एंड सर्जिंग ब्रेकर। ओशन बॉटम का या सी बॉटम का टोपोग्राफी जैसा है, उसकी स्टीपनेस जैसी है, उस पर डिपेंड करेगा स्पिलिंग ब्रेकर, plunging breaker or surging breaker. So, if we see here this diagram, you can see the 3 types of breakers over here, in which we can find that the how the waves, they are dissipating their energy at the shore. So, spilling breaker will be quieter, it's a flat bottom, it will bring its energy slowly and then it will spill it off. Wo कोस्ट पे अपनी एनर्जी को डिसिपेट करेंगे। प्लंजिंग ब्रेकर, इट बिकम नाउ द द फ्लैट, द सी बॉटम बिकम्स मोर स्टीप ओवर हियर एंड द प्लंजिंग ब्रेकर्स दे ब्रिंग दिस एनर्जी विद ग्रेटर स्पीड एंड देन दे हिट इट ऑन द कोस्ट। व्हाइल इन द सर्जिंग ब्रेकर्स हैव द स्टीपेस्ट सी बॉटम्स एंड ओवर हियर दे hit the coast, bringing the energy, but this energy is directed oceanward. ये energy जो है, क्योंकि इसकी steepness बढ़ गई coast की, तो इसकी जो energy है, जो ये breaker की, it will be directed towards the ocean rather than towards the coast. Okay, so if we see over here, that this is the flat bottom where we can find the breakers bringing the energy towards the coast on a very quieter manner, followed by the plunging breaker where the crest it becomes over steep, and you can see here how the dissipation of energy is towards the open ocean, followed by the surging breaker where the bottom is very steep and they are unable to carry the energy further towards the coast, so they dissipate it here only in the ocean, in the open ocean.